Hi, I'm Jacob Wagner. In this video, I'm going to talk about the noise effector. We have the same setup as before, 10 clones in a linear cloner, and we're going to add a new effector and change the effector type to noise. We are then going to turn on position, go into our position Y and set that to 200. Now you can see that we are getting a noise pattern. The noise is quite similar to the wiggle, but it's a little bit different in the way that it's creating a pattern. The wiggle is completely random. This is a noise pattern. So it is kind of random, but as you can see, they are also connected in this random wave. If we go into the effector settings, first we have a random seed. With the random seed, you can get different random results as always. Then we have scale. This noise pattern doesn't rely on index numbers. It always relies on the position of the clones. This is why with noise, we can always take the cloner and we could drag it around and it will be dragged around into this noise pattern. So scale is the scale of this pattern. If we set scale down to something like 50, then the scale of the waves is going to be much smaller. If we take it up to something like 200, then we're going to get much smoother waves. In this case, I think 100 was appropriate. The speed is, of course, the speed of the clones. So we could take that down to 5, and now they're going to move slower. Or we could take it up to 20, and now they're going to be much faster. The offset values can be used to offset the pattern of the noise. So we can offset the X value. And since it's a 3D noise pattern, you can offset both the X, the Y, and the Z value. So in this case, we got something that's horizontal. It makes sense perhaps to animate the offset X. If it was vertical, it might make more sense to animate the offset Y. Let's set back to 0. If you animate the offset, a lot of the time you want to switch off use time. So when use time is off, it's not going to animate at all before you start keyframing some of these offset values. The last two settings, absolute and sync values, are exactly the same as previously covered in the other videos. So I'm just going to stop the video right here. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.